We love building home servers, and apparently so do you. They're great, but what on earth are you supposed to do with them? Okay, you might need the odd virtual machine or storage vault or media streamer, and that would explain, you know, something like this. But what is this? And this? And this? Y'all clearly either got too much money, or you just love your day job managing IT so huggy-muggy much that you just can't wait to do it some more when you get home. I mean, that's clearly the vibe with our first setup here. This looks incredible.
You spent some time on this.
Got a little bit of consumer level gear down there, an old Nook and what seems to be just like an office UPS, but like, what does he need a Fortinet firewall for at home?
You're like my mate Kevin. Shout out Kevin. He loves his Fortinet. Comes with backdoors pre-baked in, baby. This dude is a total dork. Like in a good way though.
This is his toys.
This is his outside. You don't touch grass, you touch cables.
Seems like you're doing good work.
He's doing interesting stuff.
And cool. I'm doing an interesting segue to our sponsor.
Ugreen. They've partnered with the makers of Genshin Impact to bring you a limited edition bundle themed after the character Kinish and his dragon companion,
Ahau.
Learn more about the high performance charging solution it comes with using our link today.
This is the back of it. Do we have a front picture?
Wait,
this is kind of, what?
Is this even plugged in?
This is all zip ties though, oh no.
How do you have this many zip ties for cable management and still end up with it looking like this? Oh man, you need so many tips. Tech tips even. Don't put your access point on a metal surface.
Yep.
I mean, this looks like a cobbled together rack for learning, which is totally respectable.
Sure.
If they're doing it for learning, maybe learn how to not use zip ties.
You can even see that the problem has already propagated because these were the first two cables he had and then he had to add a third. Yes. So he just zip tied over the existing two plus the third.
Oh no, is this in a shipping container?
A steel box.
Whoa, buddy!
Dude,
I love it!
That is awesome. Look at the servers just sitting on the side there on the back shelf.
This is sick!
Yo!
Oh, it's got a little workstation too. This is the dream.
Dude, this is like so clean.
Yeah, look, it's got the tool organizers. Everything's in like nice little buckets.
Wait.
This is what I wish our server closet could look like.
I buried 100 meters of fiber up the driveway. Oh, that's awesome!
Yeah, that's the coolest one by far so far.
You win.
Wait, is there before and after?
I thought this was a shelf. Sorry, yeah. I thought you were getting to the post.
No, this is the shelf. No, this is the post.
Oh,
this is the whole thing. This is respectable. He's running Proxmox. A lot of Proxmox out here.
What is your setup,
what
dude?
What is he doing?
Before and after.
Oh, is it before or after? I mean, it's not much better. Is this like a Faraday cage he's built?
Oh, yeah. These might be like small cells.
They are.
He works in the cellular space and does a lot of testing. If you're not familiar, it's basically like your own mini cell tower.
Which is extremely illegal.
Well, unless you have a Faraday that.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think that's how that works, but.
I don't know.
That is sick.
That is so cool.
This is really sick.
I'm gonna write this one down.
But why do you have two what appear to be identically configured switches up here?
I think they're the same, they're just different labels of different generations.
Yeah, is this like a fully redundant, like high availability setup at home?
So what do you do with all this networking? There is no servers in here.
Is there not?
There's none. r/homelab, it's not like r/battlestation where you just, you know what they're doing with it. There's a VR headset, they're, you know, doing some stuff. This is like, look at all the stuff I have. Guess, bitch.
Wow, that's a lot of storage.
It's a lot of 2.5-inch bay storage.
Wow.
So these are like SAS drives.
Yeah, the frequency in there keeps teenagers away.
Yeah.
This one's really clean.
It is.
Show me your back fat, but like.
Jesus, okay. He's got a lock. It's where he keeps the drugs, I guess.
It's where he keeps the receipts from his wife. Yeah, it cost me $12.
You spent, well, I probably did.
Oh, is it Christmas lab?
Ah.
With better cable management than most of the things that we've seen so far.
And you notice like the lack of zip ties?
It's a Christmas tree. I mean, that's more use than some of these people are doing to their home labs, it seems like.
I almost wish it was AI. because somehow it's more painful for me that the human effort rather than the electricity was wasted building this.
This is why your support tickets aren't being answered.
This is your home lab? This is nicer than our infra.
Still technically a home lab, but I think home data center is more appropriate. Why are you making me feel inadequate like this?
Oh, okay, yeah, I'm,
Danny needs to go to the bathroom for a minute.
I just need everybody to leave.
Wow. What? What do you have plugged into this? What is all this stuff?
So in the comments they say, Jeff, who's the OP, is the CTO of SureScripts.
Okay.
What are you doing in your house, dude?
Cool.
Okay.
Oh, I love it. Very DIY, very functional.
Nice and small, out of the way.
Yeah.
Oh, look. See, look, he's got a diagram. Wow.
Now we can see
Home
exactly
media,
what's going
ISO
on.
ISO repository.
ISO repository. Yeah. Sure. Very modest, very functional.
Yeah.
Full view of the home lab. Oh, look, this guy's got captions. Wow.
Oh, it's in a built-in.
No way.
Oh, that's sick.
Custom soundproofing for silence and integration with home automation and energy management.
That's kind of cool.
That's pretty cool. How do you have that much networking in your home?
Really? You're gonna ask that question?
Hey, look.
This has to be a whole house control or something.
Yeah, like he's got a smart house. It's all like Control 4. That's why there's so many Ethernet
and
cables.
He's built it dedicated new.
When they built the house, they put the closet in. This yeah. is...
You knew what you're about, and I respect that greatly.
Apparently the servers are inaudible.
Stable 30 degrees Celsius.
2.5 gig
yeah, that's
to
what
all
you need.
Rooms.
A leak sensor above the rack to shut off the AC.
Starts out as, I want an S. This is how he started.
I think this is called gateway drug.
Bruh.
Wow. What a battle station.
Yeah.
I've never understood monitor setups like this.
No?
Because it's too much. You cannot use that much monitor. It's not even efficient. Like, this actually makes you slower, unless you're like a stock trader.
Aren't those for like doing car detailing?
What? Oh, those light bars? Yeah,
yeah, like the
this
hex
is
lights?
Just, this whole subreddit is just like wealth shaming. Like it actually is.
Poor.
That looks awesome.
Oh, is this the same dude?
The CTO.
Oh, the same
this
guy?
Is this freaking guy?
I understand why this guy is so into it because he is the CTO of whatever company. So at some point, I'm imagining he used to actually get to do stuff and now he just tells people to do stuff. Or
this is like Linus doesn't get to do things around the office because he has people for that now. Yeah. And this guy goes home and like, I remember when I started.
Huh?
7 terabytes of RAM.
Huh? What are you doing? When is too much? This is
$40,000 ago.
This is a rhetorical question.
15,000 watts?
What?
What are you even doing?
I need to like check myself before I end up like this.
75 to 90% of it is off most of the time. So he just has it.
Yeah, I have a home lab.
But I don't use it, but I have it.
48 node cluster in the garage.
Whoa. On $20 shelves.
Yeah, with $2 power strips.
Oh my goodness.
The shelves are not the...
How have they not melted?
Now that looks like something that I would build.
Spoiler, it doesn't perform great.
Self-destruct after 20 to 24 nodes.
I mean, this is a way of finding that out. You use cheap old hardware, you try stuff, and hey, at least we know what this was actually for.
He actually did something with it.
Yeah. I love it then.
Yep.
Officially love it. Whoa! Designed my own storage chassis with 56 drive bays. Okay, that's pretty cool.
Nice.
This is some Frankenstein level stuff. I love it. That is pretty sleek for a custom case.
This is really sick though. I mean,
yeah, I
want to
do that.
I have had thoughts of doing something like this so many times and I've kind of been surprised that nobody else has done it. Mm-hmm. The big thing is the connectivity. Because you can make something that's like mostly 3D printable. You can make a 3D printed drive enclosure, but how do you connect them all? And this guy made some custom PCBs for it. That's not something that you can 3D print.
No.
At least not in its entirety.
No need to pay for birth control anymore.
Oh my.
Are you sure? Are you sure? Because when she comes over and sees this, she might be like, wow, that's a big scope.
Siglind, we've got a digital storage oscilloscope. We've got another oscilloscope. We've got a...
There's another HP, like the vintage HP stuff.
This is a spectrum that analyzer.
That is like the best stuff. This National is Instruments as well. Oh my God.
Well, this is interesting.
This looks like a toy.
That is super cool.
Monty?
3D printed mini rack.
What am I even looking at?
The power supply on the side there.
Yeah.
A whole bunch of like Pi compute modules maybe?
Yeah, server rack for Pis. That's so cool. And some Intel Nooks as well, 7 inches wide. So it's only about this big, which is a perfectly okay size.
I'm no hardware engineer, so this is likely a fire hazard.
I am feeling very inspired.
Right? To do stuff. What are you going to do with the stuff, though, Dan?
Well, I mean, one of them is a machine learning server, and I use it to learn full stack dev and Proxmox and stuff like that. So and
then, of course, what you're saying is?
Piracy.
Okay.
Everything always comes back to piracy.
Oh, my God.
Is this a little lighting grid?
The little lighting truss is interesting.
Whoa!
That is hot.
This is kind of up your alley too, eh?
Yeah, he's got the
yeah, mm-hmm. The
I want to do that.
Truss.
That's, I've never even considered doing truss.
Yo!
Whoa.
What a f***ing nerd! He's using the truss to mount his monitors. Oh. That stuff's expensive.
Yeah, it's pretty, yeah. Why he's got road cases. Yo. That's all audio equipment.
Yo!
Yeah.
This is what Dan wishes he was.
Oh, right. LTTstore.com. The hat.
And the shirt.
Oh, yeah, and the shirt. It's just a blank black shirt, but it's nice.
It's a Pi cluster. It's a Kubernetes Pi cluster.
Oh.
See, I love these things. They're so cute when people do Pi clusters. They're not cost effective in terms of like the performance per dollar in any way, shape, or form.
Yeah, but they're performance per square foot.
Nope, still not that.
Oh.
Yeah, they're just cute.
Sharing the heat sinks between like two machines each.
And it looks like they just took these heat pipes and just friggin' sent it on here. 100% unnecessary work. The best kind of work. I could just put a fan on it.
But why?
But why do that when I
have
could...
these heat sinks?
Exactly, and these heat pipes. And I've always wanted to learn how to bend heat pipes.
Yeah.
I'm in your head. I get you, I see you.
I have been you.
HomeLab meets Battle Station. Hey,
that's cute.
That,
I love it.
That's sweet. Unrated.
And the desk lighting matches the rack lighting.
As long as this isn't too loud, I love this setup. Wait, okay, help me.
Wait, is that an Alienware?
You're a home labber. You bought an Alienware desktop?
Mobile home lab. Okay, sick. That is a very rugged crate.
That looks military.
That's pretty cool.
That's cool. A little for you or so?
Yeah.
Working overseas for the next year and had to miniaturize most of my normal setup so I can take it with me.
To do what with? To do what with?
It's like a laptop, but 100 pounds.
Why?
What's a grandpa home lab?
Whoa, that's ancient.
Oh, that
Holy
is a grandpa
crap.
Home lab. Early 90s? Maybe
yeah,
mid-90s?
Maybe late 80s even.
No.
Are those 5-inch bays?
The color's not right for late 80s.
It was EOL in 2007. Yeah, this is ancient. It's probably older than me.
Is there a lab here somewhere?
I think so.
Oh, there's a monitor.
There's some networking. There's definitely some servers.
Oh my God, this is me. This is what I'm not this bad, but I'm close to this bad. There is stuff actually running in here. Is oh it, God.
You know who I think can help you with this though? Our sponsor.
Ugreen. Travelers, hop into the world of Teyvat now for even longer thanks to Ugreen's charging solutions. They've partnered with the makers of Genshin Impact to bring you a unique bundle themed after Kinish, the 5-star Dendro DPS character, and his dragon companion with an attitude problem, Ahau. It's got an output of up to 100 watts through a single port, or up to 130 watts if you're charging two devices at once. It even has a TFT display for you to check your charging status and remaining battery life. The bundle also comes with a 65-watt Nexode GaN charger that can charge three devices at once, a Magflow Theon-1 Qi-2 certified wireless charging station, a 100-watt USB-C cable, and a cable tie organizer. What more could you want? So, whether you're logging in on the go or sitting comfortably on your couch, the Ugreen Genshin Impact Kinish bundle can keep you adventuring for longer. Pick up one using our link and get up to 30% off, and check out their massive giveaway while you're at it.
If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to check out the one where we looked at r/tech support gore. That was a whole pile of nightmare.